Hello students, today we will solve one more problem which is related to product diversification. Here the problem is given for the product diversification in a situation wherein demand for the existing products are actually reducing. Okay, so in this particular problem, a company is actually manufacturing two different products at present, and you know, details relating cost details regarding those two products are given here, and the summarized profitability of the company for those two products are given here. Okay, and in the coming year, that means in the next year, when the product A and product B, the production for product A and product B is reduced by 20% and 40% respectively because of fall in demand. Okay, and because of that demand, but because of that particular reason, the company is actually planning to introduce a new product called product C, and the cost details regarding this particular product are mentioned here. So based on this particular information, you are required to prepare a product wise and overall budget for 2012. So you are required to prepare a product wise and overall budget for 2012, and also you need to make a conclusion on whether to make a product diversification or not. That means state what conclusion can be drawn from the budget of 2012 by using marginal costing technique. Okay, so the basic information about the products the company is actually producing and about the product which is actually planning to introduce in the coming year. So those basic information are recorded in the earlier stage. Okay, in the solution part, first we are recording the basic data and we are determining the unit contribution for all the three products. So product A and product B both are existing product. Product C is a new product. So these information are given in the problem itself, so there is no any specific calculation that you have to do. And only one thing you need to make sure is the number of unit expected to be sold in 2012. That means after reduction in demand, so the product A is reduced by 20%. Okay, that means 6 lakh for 6 lakh 20% is 1 lakh 20,000. If you reduce 1 lakh 20,000 units out of this particular number, you will get 4 lakh 80,000. Same way, 40% reduction in demand for product B, so ultimately we are getting 1 lakh 80,000. So this is basic information for all the three products. And here the amount of profit earned for the year 2011 for first two products, that means existing products that we are calculating here. So contribution from sales of product A, so unit contribution is there, that is 2,70,000 for 6 lakh unit, that will come up to 16,20,000. And unit contribution for product B is 3.80, and the total number of units is 3 lakh units. So the total contribution for product B is 11,40,000. Total contribution of these two products A and B is 27,60,000. So out of which, if you reduce the fixed cost, you will get the profit of rupees 17,70,000. So for any working notes, I have mentioned few numbers here, so you can go with the working notes also to understand how this particular information is calculated. So this particular contribution and this particular profit is used to analyze after diversification. So whether the company is making any profitable changes or profitable move or not, that is what we are going to see. Okay, and finally we need to prepare a product wise and overall budget for the year 2012. So this is product wise budget for the year 2012. So here for all the three products, and if diversified, that means what is going to happen, product A will be there, product B will be there, and along with that product C will also be there. If not diversified, that means even after decrease in demand for product A and B, only two products, that means product A and B, are continued with production and sales. That means no new product is introduced. So in this condition, what is going to happen? And if diversification is going to happen, what is going to happen? We are going to compare and analyze the situation. Okay, so the cost of material for three products are taken here. So this particular table is for 1,000 rupees. This is 4,80,000. That means you can calculate by using the number of units and material cost, the number of units and direct wages cost. That is, per unit information is already shown in the previous page. So using those information we can calculate. So just like this. Okay, and so cost of material are recorded here, direct wages, factory overhead. Only variable part is considered here, and other overhead variable expenses are also considered here. So this information is totally related to variable expenses for all the three products. And total variable cost of sales is 1584, 1116, 1100. So this information is variable cost, total variable cost. So with the help of this information and sales revenue for all the three products, we are calculating the contribution for all the three different products. Okay, and for if diversified, these three columns are added here. If not diversified, only, that means only two products are continued with the production, so these two information are added here. Okay, now so after adding all this information, so if diversified, the total contribution is 22,80,000, and if not diversified, the total contribution is 19,80,000. In this, fixed cost is not going to change irrespective of the level of activity. So here the fixed cost is 9,90,000 and 9,90,000. This information is also shown in the working notes. Okay, after reducing the fixed cost, the company is actually earning 12,90,000 as profit if diversified. If not diversified, 9,90,000. In the previous page, we have observed that the company was getting a contribution of 27,60,000, right? 27,60,000. And because of demand, decline in demand, the contribution is reduced to 19,80,000, right? So there is a reduction in contribution by 7,80,000. And however, introduction of the new product with no additional fixed cost brings in the additional contribution. Even if we are losing on the contribution of 7,80,000, at least by introducing a new product, we can gain further contribution, that is up to 3 lakh towards the profit of the company. So thus it is, this is very important for the company, are very profitable and necessity for the company to introduce the product. Okay, so by introducing the product, the company can make additional profit of rupees 3 lakh. So that we can see here. Okay, even after there is a decrease in profit by 4,80,000, if you compare it with the previous year profit, that you can see in the previous page, that is 17,70,000. Here after diversification we are getting 12,90,000. So even after diversification the profit is reduced, but still we prefer to go with the diversification. Why? Means because if we are not going with the diversification, we need to reduce the production as demand is not there. So when we reduce the production for product A and product B, the total profit would come up to 9,90,000. So comparing these two situations, it is better to introduce a new product, so which is going to reduce the burden for the company. Okay, thank you.